a dark cloud over the city of Fort Oglethorpe for more than 30 years. Back in 1979, a 15-year-old, Jody Anderson, was found slouched up against a fence with a rope around his neck. At first glance, it looked like a suicide. However, years later, investigators ruled it was a homicide. So what happened? WDEF News' Alicia Searle cracks open tonight's cold case report.
What started out as just a little Friday night football quickly ended like a scene out of a Friday night fiction film.
She told me that Jody was dead.
They're words that Joan Green can barely whisper, even after 30 years.
Jody was leaned up against the fence with a rope around his neck, what appeared to be a suicide at first glance. However, we no longer believe that's the case.
He loved people.
But in September of 1979, that seemingly simple, carefree life came to an end after a Friday night football game. He was found dead just feet away from his girlfriend's house with this rope wrapped around his neck.
They tried to say it was suicide, but we knew better. We knew.
Besides a mother's intuition, Green says, when she saw her son at the funeral home, he had cigarette burns on his arms. And that's not all.
I moved his hand, and it was just all messed up, like somebody had stomped it.
All red flags, family members say. However, their concerns fell on deaf ears, as suicide was ultimately listed on the initial report.
In the very beginning, this case was assigned to a very inexperienced patrol officer. Our department had no detectives at the time. For some reason, there was no autopsy performed.
So, case closed, right? Well, it was for several years, until the mid-80s, when a new investigator dove a little deeper into the case and found a suspect that had one jaw-dropping story to tell, a story that involved several teenagers.
Befriended Mr. Anderson, talked him into getting into their van to, I believe, go to a party. And
that ride, police now say, ended here at this national park, where the suspect describes in detail how Anderson was stoned, hung, and then propped up against his girlfriend's house.
What would you think if somebody confessed, and would you not think that's good enough?
Well, police say that confession was not good enough because the suspect was deemed mentally incompetent. He's now refusing to talk. And evidence to back his claim was and still is a big problem.
We have absolutely no physical evidence.
And that's in part because the rope that was found on Jody was actually tampered with and taken home by one of the officers at the time.
Who used it on camping trips. It hurts me to say that.
A botched police case and back to square one. Now this new police force is left picking up the pieces. In Walker County, Alicia Searle, WDF News 12.
A motive for the case is still under investigation now. However, police say one of the suspects may have been infatuated with Anderson's girlfriend. If you have any information on the case, call Fort Oglethorpe Police.